milestone in your life. I am honored to have been asked to be your Class Day speaker. I want to take this time to share my thoughts on how endless your opportunities are. You must always keep your dreams alive. What you do with your life is determined by one person, you. A dream is only impossible if you let it be impossible. With determination, commitment, and perseverance, you can reach your goals. My mother believed that a good education is the key to open doors of opportunities. This was her dream for her four children. Keeping her eyes on that dream, she instilled in us the importance of taking responsibility, of being honest, and of maintaining high moral values. She set the stage for us to understand that we can reach our dreams. I would like to share a story with you. I was born in a free Cuba. My parents' dream for my three sisters and me was for one day to be able to come to the United States and be educated here. But as you know, in 1959, Fidel Castro defeated one of Cuba's many dictators and took control of the country, making it an absolute communist satellite for the former Soviet Union. In what seemed like an instant, we lost our fundamental freedoms, our basic rights as human beings, we lost our dignity, our freedom of choice, and all global opportunities. In a situation like this, the value of freedom becomes priceless, even to a 12-year-old. In 1962, with my father in the house arrest, my mother brought my three sisters to me to Miami, Florida, and immediately we became Cuban refugees. Suddenly we found ourselves in a foreign country, unable to speak the language, with literally only the clothes on our backs. Through my mother's perseverance and hard work, she found an opportunity for me. The United Presbyterian Church that we were attending in Miami granted me an academic and work scholarship to attend a private high school in Tennessee. I spent the next 3 years there. While attending high school, I worked in the school's dairy farm, milking cows, and loading hay. I also cleaned bathrooms, washed dishes, and fired the school's heating system with coal. Between studies and work, I was also involved in the school's sports program. After my graduation from high school, I continued to dream, the same dream that my mother had worked so hard for. I earned a Bachelor's of Science degree from East Tennessee State University and a Master's of Arts degree from Appalachian State University. I began my employment here at Halifax County Hospital in August 1974, and will complete that journey next month as I retire. As it did in 1962 for me, this Cuban boy, America Skills offers endless opportunities for those willing to follow my mother's advice, to be determined, committed, honest, and responsible. In my retirement letter, I wrote the following. I have thoroughly enjoyed my 40-year tenure with the Halifax County School System. I appreciate the privilege of working for the school system and the opportunities that I have been afforded over the years. I have received many blessings working with the administration, the faculty, and the many students whose life I hope I have touched. Class of 2014, I have watched you grow and mature over the past 4 years into young men and women. I look at you and see the faces of the future, faces filled with opportunities. You will experience struggles and success, times of sadness and of joy. But keep your eyes fixed on your goals and never, ever give up, and seize every opportunity you can that will contribute to your success and happiness. Congratulations and good luck. And as Arnold Schwarzenegger said, hasta la vista, baby.
Durable.
Mr. Chan.
Mr. Chan.
Mr. Chan.
sign the project, like a month and a half in advance, do you?
Thank you. I miss our combination. I bring that out of that's my story. I miss team working, combination.
Thank you. Thank you. Now that you've graduated, just remember, bosses usually don't accept notes from your mom.
Follow your passion. Stay true to yourself. Never follow anyone else's path. Unless you're in the woods and you're lost and you see a path, then by all means, follow that path. Thank you. A word of advice. Life doesn't give you the people you want. It gives you the people you need to make you the person you're meant to be.
Many valuable lessons were learned that we carry on we had a new superintendent. The Boston bombings went off and the Sandy Hook Elementary School tragedy occurred. Frozen yogurt came to South Boston and was opening Emojis in Riverdale. And last but not least, the chorus released the hit song, SOL.
And the senior year, we finally made it. The mission was finally complete. The comic crazies came back from the dead, and every basketball game was really hype. Halifax beat GW this year. That's probably the best game of the year. And we senior couldn't complain about all these snow days we had, am I right?
Now we will ask Hamilton Richardson to come to the stage. He will be singing an original song and is dedicated in memory of classmate Jared Lennon.
Thank you.
Thank you, Hamilton. Now we are waiting for the moment that many of you have been waiting for. The list of class favorites, class will and testament, and senior superlatives.
Mr.
Best Legs, Keith Cruz, Mary Popek. Best Smile, Nico Lawrence and Ashley Hill. Best Body, James Hallis and Gabby Mendy. Best Strut, Keon Spradley and Gabby Mendy.
Best dancer, Larry.
teacher's pet, Ryan Powell and Noah Worsley. Life of the party, Chase Wilkerson and Mandria Brandon. Most likely to be late for graduation, Andrew Hatcher and Sierra Abernathy. Most likely to be a gold digger, Dustin Cruz and Taylor Strange. Biggest attitude, Dion Lassiter and Amani Brayboy.
while you're standing